There we go. Let's fix that. There. Bam. There it is. All right, people. How's everybody doing? Long time no see. Here's my little Starbucks in case the Starbucks owner guy forgets. I keep forgetting his name. Who is it? Is it Bezos? No, it's not Bezos. That's Amazon. Anyways. Some cool name. Alright, guys. I hope everyone's doing great. I haven't done a video in a little while. Well, I painted a lot. I just haven't done a video in a little while. And I'm back. Let's do another one of this sessions. Oil painting sessions. With... your host here, Jose Trujillo, and this one's again in one of my small canvas board paintings. I love these ones. They're great for all sorts of things, you know, if you're traveling or you're doing plein air paintings, open air paintings, or if you're just if you like to do I don't know, practice on a small one before you head on to a bigger canvas or whatever you do, it doesn't matter. Let's get to it. All right, so today I'm gonna do a sort of like a Fender body guitar, Fender guitar, Strat. I used to be, I guess I still am, but I used to be a guitarist. And and my favorite guitar was I'm sorry guys, for some of you guys who are like, no, don't say that. Yep, sorry. It was a Fender Strat. Why? I don't know. They're just super cool. I feel like Fender guitars are just... I don't know. Sorry for you, I don't know, less tall people out there. I'm a Fender type of guy. I'm sorry. No, I'm really joking. I loved playing any guitar. I think any guitar would do the trick. Especially if it was a good guitar, you know? It didn't matter whether it was a Fender or whatever. That didn't matter to me. What did matter was that the amplifier mattered. That's really what mattered. Box amplifier. The guitar, not so much. The amp is what mattered. Oh man, I used to love playing the guitar. It's so sad I don't do it anymore. But I just, you know, I find myself just finding other things to do, like painting now. But I was pretty good. I was a pretty good guitarist. I did lead guitar and you know, I wasn't so bad. What am I doing here? I think I'm overthinking this thing. Yeah, okay. Make it look like a Rickenbacker now. Remember you guys, there's nothing wrong you can do. And if someone says that there's something wrong you can do, I think that when it comes to painting, I think they are not right up there. Painting is, again, is that thing that, you know, it doesn't matter how you do it, because it's so personal. Painting's so personal, and I really want to drive that, you know, that message home with you guys. Painting is a personal thing. It's not there's no one right way, you know? There's no one way. I think that's what makes it so cool. There we go. So, So far, it's like, what? But it will be there. Believe me. Believe me, Simba. Believe me. Here we go. So I've been very focused on an exhibit I'm working on for Tubac, Arizona, and just getting that, you know, that ready. Exhibits are the coolest thing. It just, you know, they can get. I can see why some artists avoid them. I can see why. Sometimes they, you know, they could be overwhelming because they take all this energy, right? Because they require a lot of attention. So I can see why some artists are like, man, I don't like doing exhibit. Sometimes I'll say that, but like, oh man, you know, especially when you're having fun with something else and then you get invited to an exhibit. You don't know whether to get happy or or start going, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. From all the work you gotta do. But nevertheless, as I like to use that word, nevertheless, it's totally cool. Doesn't really matter. It's a great experience. I think that's what's so cool about being an artist, you know, just in general, because you get to try out different stuff. Freedom, I appreciate people have been writing about how they've been really enjoying these videos, you know, and how it's giving you guys some freedom to paint. I feel like my job is done. I must now do something else. I love it because you know, you get so much, how can I say this? It's so strange because I believe that painting is one of those things that you just, you know, there is no right or wrong way, but yet we find ourselves doing that to each other, especially to each other. But really, there is no right or wrong way. It's the channel you've created, you know. It's the way you've carved the way you create your work. It's really that. It comes down to that. It's not a. There is no. No, this is the right way of doing it, or, you know, if there is a right way of doing it, we'd all pick the same. And that's not the reality. The reality is that there is no right way of doing it. There is only doing it. And I enjoy when I hear people say, you know what? It's liberating to see you paint when they see me paint or whatever. You know? Not to... toot my own horn or whatever. But... I must say it is. It is liberating. Painting, it's one of those activities that I believe you should give yourself a break. I'm not saying you should stop practicing. Okay, don't get me wrong. Don't say, well, if this is what you're gonna do or whatever. No, what I'm saying is give yourself a break. Allow yourself to mess up. And then come back to it. Allow yourself to not know what you're doing. Especially that. You know? Allow yourself to express, to experience, to experiment. allow yourself to be wrong, quote unquote. You'll never be right unless you're wrong. I know it's one of those paradoxical things, but I have a hard time sometimes. Paradoxical things. It's one of those things, you know. You want to be. You want to be so right. Sometimes, I know because this has happened to me. You want to be so right that you rather do nothing. Many times. And keep your right. Then the possibility of doing something wrong. And I've learned over and over that I'd rather do something wrong and work on it as I go, than wait it to be right, you know, then you gotta give yourself that chance. It's really a gift. You're giving it yourself. And many of us don't don't do that to ourselves, you know? You gotta give yourself the gift of messing up. It is a gift. It is a... Why? Because that is where you open. It's in the mess ups. My mom used to say, there I go with my mama, you know? she used to have this saying that I always loved growing up. Well, I didn't love everything she'd tell me, right? Like clean your room, stuff like that. I was like, come on, mom. But she used to have this cool saying. Right? Those of you who know that I mentioned to you, she's very spiritual. She was very spiritual woman. But she had this saying. That rings in my head many times, and it's helped me to become a better person, I believe. And I'm not saying a better person as in a good person, but as in a someone who can embrace life better. That's what I mean. Not good or bad or nice or whatever. It's just someone who can embrace life. Just a little better. She used to tell me, only when you mess up is when you learn. And it sounds like so dull in English. And she used to say in Spanish, echando a perder se aprende. When you're messing up is when you're learning. You have to allow yourself to F up. You just have to. It's so hard for us to do. You know, it's so difficult because we want to be right. I heard this sales guru. I listened to some of them. You know, just success or sales or whatever. This guy would say something funny that I thought it was funny, but if you really think about it, there's nothing funny about it. if you start thinking about it, it's more like, oh man, I have to really check myself. But he says, you will die being right. And when I first heard it, I was like, well, what do you mean you will die being right? Like, what does that mean? You know. But after a while, the thought started sinking in, and I was like, oh, I get what this guy's talking about. He's saying you will, I mean, after listening to more of his message, right? It didn't just happen like that. But he was saying, you know, you'd rather be right than accept that you may be wrong. You know, and fix it or work on your thing or whatever. You'd rather be right. It really meant a lot to me when I heard that. Because I told myself, check this out. Why? I don't know, you guys. It's just, it comes to me. It comes to me. It's just right here. I feel the power. This person asked me why I laugh so much. question was, pretty, I think it was good. It was crude. It was to the point. I was like, why do you laugh so much? I just think life is funny. I think that anything that is anything that's serious, beware. Beware of the proper way of doing things. Beware of the proper way of being. Beware of the proper way, the right way. And I understand there's technical aspects in life and things, right? Of course, everything that we do, whatever it is, skill has a technical aspect to it, right? Especially in certain jobs or certain things, of course. You don't want your surgeon laughing. Or maybe you do, I don't know. He's taking care of your body, right? Of course. But you want him, maybe you want him or her laughing. A little bit, in the sense of not being so serious. You know? Not being so serious. Beware. This is one of the things that has become true to me. Beware of the seriousness. The seriousness of life is usually associated with pain. And you don't escape it by laughing. When I laugh or when you laugh, we're not escaping it. It's not like we're like, oh, I'm pretending it's not here. No. It's not a laughter that is born out of, what's that word? I forgot the word. It's a laughter that is born out of a knowing that life is not that serious. And you know, that's why I love seeing some of the, and I'm not trying to be disrespectful with anyone here, okay, in your beliefs or religions, everyone. I think this guitar is like 12 strings, so I'd like to see some of the sculptures of the way they represent the Buddha, because he seems like he's having a blast in life. Because that's life, you know? We're here for I know it's so cliche, but we're here for some time. None of us are really here for that long. We're here for some time only. And life can be very difficult. I think we've all experienced that. Life can be very demanding. It can be very difficult. We can have a lot of challenges. Some people have many more challenges than others. But laughter, whenever possible, whenever we have that moment to do it, we should squeeze the shit out of it. Because it grounds us, it brings us back. It takes us out of our head. I think that's why every time comedians say something, it sounds so true. I don't know if you notice, regardless of the type of comedy, when comedians say something, it sounds like this. Like they sound like funny spiritual teachers. They're so comical about it, because I think that how else is something, you know, so deep going to touch us other than with laughter. You know? Man, check this out. Check this guitar out. Bam, bam, bam! There it is. Anyways, you guys. Here I go. And put some je ne sais quoi gray in the background. Because I think that gray will look pretty cool with the little salmon red that I put there. I don't know why. Just, it feels right. The moment has called it. The cards have been given to us already. We have to do the best we can with them. So I love, my dad was a cowboy. Yes, I told you guys before. My dad was a cowboy. Both of my parents were ranchers in Mexico. And my dad was one of those charro cowboys, horsemen. They had the coolest sayings over there. Well, anyway, right? But I love those sayings. Some of their insightful words of wisdom. And one of the things that in the rodeo, the Mexican rodeo, which is the charrería, they're called suertes. Every to put it loosely, every trick they have to perform, whether it's roping or whatever it is, it's called a suerte. And a suerte means, how could we translate it? It's referring to luck. There's some sort of luck playing in there. And sometimes when they refer to, they're talking about life, right? They're talking about life. It's just like in Spain, I believe, by the way, no one told me this, but just by looking at it, the sport of bullfighting, which is no bueno anymore, for good reasons. But you can see that how deep that thing must, that sport must have called people to be around it. Because again, it's a reminder, you are the matador, and the bull is the force of life pushing back at you. And sometimes you feel like the matador and sometimes you feel like the bull. Regardless of what role you're playing, life can feel that heavy. And there's sort of a luck, that it's been given to you. And that's what that has been given to you. Anyways, I managed to go into my deep thoughts, you guys. But this is what this is about, That's art. That's really art. You take something simple and you look at it. You look at it, and you look at it, and you go deep into it without there being a right or a wrong. There is no right or wrong. Sometimes I'll paint with speed, sometimes I'll be slower. It doesn't matter what the thing is. There is no right or wrong. We create those ideas. Those are man-made. Right and wrong are man-made. We create them to justify not our perception. I wouldn't say our perception, but our judgment on things. We're constantly judging as human beings. This is something that that we do, sadly, but it's there, so whatever, you know. Constantly judging ourselves, especially, not just others, but especially ourselves, one way or another. And we fall into the trap of right and wrong and good and bad and all this nonsense, especially in our work, where we should be most, we should be experiencing the most, the highest levels of gratitude in life, in our work, whether we work with our hands or whatever. And sometimes we go into that place where we're just judging ourselves, you know, telling ourselves, it's not right, or, you know, whatever other form of judgment we tell ourselves. It is right. I'm here to tell you that it is right. And no matter where you are in this moment, it's okay. You can only go up from there. Give yourself a break. Allow yourself to mess up. Give yourself that freedom. If you do not give yourself that freedom, doesn't matter where you go, how high you go, how good, quote unquote, you get, you'll have a hard time. I think so, anyways. Who knows? All right, peeps. I hope you guys had a great day, or if you're barely starting your day, I'm finishing up my day here, but if you guys are starting, ooh, hold on, this is the color that I wanted. I was like, where is it? It's right here. There we go. All right, you guys, this is Jose Trujillo. I am the world's greatest living artist. Why? Because I can be. And so can you. All right? Cool. Keep it cool. Keep it fresh. Thank you so much for watching. And till next time. Bye-bye.